Hey everybody, Beyondrew TV here. Welcome back to the channel and welcome back to another episode here of Thornton Hill Zoo. So today we're going to go ahead and finally wrap up the Savannah section of the zoo here with our phase three completion of the basically the male elephant, the bull elephant habitat there. So yeah, let's go ahead and move on from our main little viewing area of the savannah there and move over to our elephant area, which is right on up this way. And yeah, last time we were over this way, we didn't take a right because none of it was done yet. And oh my gosh, I missed a fence. Everyone quick, jump in the habitat. But yeah, I didn't finish any of this yet, so we haven't gone this way yet, but that has changed there. So let's go ahead and walk on over to all the new stuff there. So the first little bit there is a little bridge that I decided to kind of cover up, but if you kind of peer, I kind of left a little bit of a gap. This gap is actually purposeful. I know it looks like I just kind of missed it, but I left a little bit of gap so that you can kind of get little itty bitty views of the elephants as they kind of traverse underneath of you and everything like that. So just that's just a little itty bitty thing there. But yeah, the big thing over here is the brand new restaurant here. So yeah, this is a brand new big old sit down restaurant there, inspired by, oh, I want to say the Cincinnati or Cleveland Zoo has a sit down restaurant that is similar to this one there. But yeah, really like it because I put on a back seating here, so you have this really awesome view over here of the this is the female habitat, elephant habitat there. But yeah, you get these awesome views overlooking everything there. So yes, yeah, so, and there's only three tables available, so you know those would book that would be booked all summer and everything for that. So yeah, there's just a quick little restaurant over on this way there, and another little education talk point there where you get a nice little overhead view of the whole male elephant habitat. Originally over this way, I can't remember if I showed it off though, there used to be a little fake rock structure going up over this way. Decided to take that out, and I think it's because I've been building with S-Dan so much, but decided to use this big eucalyptus tree, which I have dubbed the S-Dan wolf tree, because he uses it in all over Siana, and when we're building in our new Beyond Wolf Nature Preserve swamp build, this tree is everywhere. So yeah, I took that out and replaced it with the big eucalyptus tree, and I love how that thing looks. I'm gonna, any future builds I do are always gonna use this big tree because it just fills out an area super nicely. And as you can see, I went ahead and did that twice there. So yeah, starting to use that tree a lot more near the end of the build here for Thornton Hills Zoo basically. But yeah, as we kind of go through our little peninsula, our little island there, oh no, my fencing didn't save here either. What the heck, it's like I deleted something and it was attached to some fencing because I am missing fencing all over. So just pretend that there's a fence here and you can't go over there. Pretending is fun. But yeah, as you come down this way, again, just kind of you're smack dab right in the middle of the two elephant habitats there. So yeah, again, you have the female and the male on that side, but yeah, just kind of like this idea of being smack dab right in the middle of them and getting views on both sides as you're kind of walking there. So yeah, as we come on down here, love doing this little part here. And again, ever since Mr. Wyatt Andrews has done the landscaping the way he did near the Sheets Aquarium, I just kind of have always liked the basically just doing more gardening. We're doing a lot more gardening rather than just randomly spamming out foliage, kind of like in a forest setting, like you see in the back there. It's very just kind of, you know, bushes and trees and all that fun stuff just thrown together. But yeah, I like the idea of just kind of gardening a lot more and actually planting things out and spacing them out and just kind of giving an order to the foliage and everything there. So yeah, just really like doing that sort of foliage work there around the male elephant habitat here. So yeah, there you go, there is that. And then as you come around this way, we have the Zoo Brew stand. Yeah, I saw this when I was just, again, looking up random reference photos. I can't even remember where this came. I think it was a Pinterest board that just randomly had this. But anyways, yeah, it's a few zoos have these little, yeah, just basically little stands that are full of beer and alcohol and all that fun stuff. A bunch of adult fun little beverages there. So yeah, I made a nice little plaza with the Zoo Brew there. So yeah, this is a fun little thing to put there. Maybe I'll use the Eben mod, the mod that Eben made, which gives us invisible shops, and maybe I can put an invisible shop right there to make it look even more like it's lived in and used and all that fun stuff there. So yeah, no, I had a lot of fun building that, making this little Zoo Brew plaza there. So But yeah, no, for the most part, that goes ahead and wraps up. I mean, oh yeah, the only other little part I did, because I got rid of the, again, the rock structure up here, did a little bit more gardening and stuff like that. So you use some of that eelgrass, that brand new eelgrass, which, man, if we could and the foliage wouldn't tank performance, I would love this to be like the actual like grass that we have. Like, I love the long grass that we have with the actual, you know, the terrain paint and stuff like that. Yeah, here, the long grass that we get, right, there you go. But there's just something about the, you see the definitive difference there. Actually, combine both, that looks really, really lush. But anyways, I wish this didn't tank performance so much, because yeah, I would have used it all over. But anyways, just some more gardening up here and a little viewpoint, this awesome little viewpoint right here with so people can get this nice, great view all the way over here. Oh my gosh, he's trying to throw it up onto the guests. Did you see that? The elephant's trying to throw the, weaponize his toys there. So anyways, yeah, this is the big grand, or not grand reveal, we've kind of seen it all the way, but this is the final look. Let me pause it while we're out here so you get a smoother look. Here's the final look at the savanna section of the whole African section of the zoo there. So yeah, overall, this has been a long time coming, but it's finally done. This is the whole African section of the zoo. So you can kind of see broken up between this path here. Here's the forests of Africa. No, I'm sorry. This is the jungles of Africa section right here. This is the forests of Africa over here. And then the savanna up over that way. So yeah, three distinct areas between the African section altogether. And yeah, it is finally all done there. So that is a huge checkbox done with the zoo there. So what's in the future? What's going on with Thornton Hills Zoo right now? Well, I don't have it. I don't have Thornton Hills Zoo, and I haven't had it for like the last about week and a half or so. The reason being, I have given it away to Wyatt Andrews again. So I think I said about a million times over that I wasn't giving the zoo away, and I had different people ask me, hey, can I take the zoo? And, you know, can I build in it and all that stuff? I was like, no, I'm going to, oh, perfect. I always click on them when they're pooping. I was like, no, I'm going to build it out. I can do it. I can do it. I got this and blah, blah, blah. And then Wyatt hit me up right about the time that I was getting involved with Mr. Estan in our brand new swamp bayou build there, and was like, hey, I have an idea for a section that many people have requested. I have an idea for an Asian adventure section. What do you think? And I was like, you know what? Your track record is more than proven. I'm about to not want to build in Thornton Hills Zoo because my inspiration is all over into Beyond Wolf Nature Preserve. It's like, yes, here you go. Here's the keys. Have fun. Don't leave any scratches on the car when you bring it back, basically, which I know he won't. So yeah, Wyatt Andrews has the zoo, has had it for a little bit, and is currently in the process of building a huge expansion, just about as big as this one, I want to say, right up and over this way, right where our boneyard is for everything. This is all going to change. He is putting in a big Asian section, which is from the very limited screenshots I've seen. I want this to be a secret for myself, but from the one or two screenshots I've seen, looks amazing. And he is also putting in a all new, very old second entrance and second parking lot up over this way as well. So this little bubble right here is getting filled in, and since it's being done by Wyatt Andrews, it's going to be huge, amazing, and be done within about 2 weeks, unlike me, which would take me like 6 months to do something like that probably, because that's just the way I build sometimes. So yeah, we're going to get that back from him, and then we're going to fill in these little gaps right here, these little sections right there, which I already have planned out. And then guess what? Bing, bam, boom. Thornton Hills is done. Bam, just like that. So yeah, probably like 6 months. I hope it doesn't take that long, but yeah, hopefully this year, Thornton Hills Zoo will be done. So yeah, with all these 1, 2, 3 expansions, this isn't a big enough area, but 3 big expansions coming into the zoo, and then we will call this one quits, my friends, and move on to the next fun thing there. So, but yeah, that is all future talk there. So yeah, the next episode of Thornton Hills Zoo, we'll probably have Mr. Wyatt Andrews on with us to hang out and talk about the all-new second entrance and Asian section and all that fun stuff there. So, cool. That's going to that's gonna go ahead and do it for the episode today. Go ahead, comment down below. What do you think of the all-new, the brand-new completed African section altogether? And, yeah, are you excited for the future expansion from Wyatt Andrews with the Asian section and all that fun stuff? Also, if this is your first time hanging out with us, don't forget, hit that subscribe button there. Hang out with us with all the live streams streams, Thornton Hills Zoo, Beyond Wolf Nature Preserve, and any of the other fun future stuff that are that will be coming on the channel there. And yeah, leave a like if you like the video. Helps out the channel, helps out the video. So hey, thanks so much everyone for hanging out. Always do appreciate it. And yeah, I will catch you in the next episode of Thornton Hills Zoo. Bye!